Are you ready? Are you ready? Oh, are you ready to go? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready to go?
Hello, it's Mr. T, and I have another calculus tutorial for us today. Today we'll be talking about two new derivative rules called the chain rule and the generalized power rule. So let's get into it. To help understand the rule and the need for the rule, let's look at a couple problems similar to what we've worked recently. And let's look at how we would do these just using our basic rules, the power rule and the constant rule. So remember, when we were doing problems like this, we would have to rewrite this. And we could either use the product rule or we could FOIL that out. Either way, so we get here negative 12x plus 9x squared. That's still f of x. And then if we apply our derivative rules, we would have negative 12 plus 18x. Now we could do the same thing here, but that's going to be quite painful because we would have to multiply this out 5 times. So this is possible, but painful. Here, we don't have any algebra we could do to expand this and get rid of this square root. So at this point, with the basic rules, this one's impossible. With what we're going to talk about today, we'll be able to easily handle all three of these examples. Before we talk about the new rules, we need to review composite functions. So in our last problem, part B, we had this problem here. Now we're going to view this as two separate functions that are create composites out of them. So we have an outside function, which I showed in blue here, which is something, an expression raised to the fifth power. So our outside function, if we call it g of x, could be x to the fifth power. Shown in red is what I call the inside function. It's inside the parentheses. And in this case, it's a linear expression, 2 minus 3x. We're going to call that function h of x. If we do a composite function, g of h of x, we will get back the f of x that we started with. If you remember, when we reviewed composite functions, we evaluate the inside function, which would in this case just be 2 minus 3x. We would be replacing h of x with this value. And now we take this expression and we put it into the x for g of x. So we would have 2 minus 3x to the fifth. So when we are working on the chain rule, we will be breaking down functions into an outer function and an inner function to apply the rule. So here we go. Here's the chain rule. So we have two functions, g of x and h of x, that each have to be separately differentiable. And if we form a new function, f of x, by taking the composite of those two functions, then the chain rule says the derivative of f of x is as shown here. Essentially, we take the derivative of the outside function and evaluate it at h of x, and we multiply that by the derivative of the inside function. So when we're multiplying here by the derivative of the inside function, we're kind of chaining together these functions. So we've got an h of x here chained together with its h prime. So that's where the name comes from. So let's look at a couple examples applying this. So if we look at those original three examples, let's go here to the more interesting one. Let's talk about b. So our outside function we're going to call g of x, and in this case would be x to the fifth. And the derivative of our outside function would be 5x to the fourth using the power rule. And h of x will be our inside function, and its derivative using the power rule and the constant rule would be negative 3. Now, if we want to find f of x, which is this function, which is g of h of x, we apply this rule. So we have to plug h of x into g prime. So the first part of the chain rule is we're going to put h of x into our derivative. So we're going to replace the x with h of x. And now we have to multiply that by the derivative of the inside function h prime. And now all we have to do is simplify. We can use the commutative property for multiplication and multiply this 5 and the negative 3. And this is our derivative of this. Now that's a lot faster than having to FOIL this out 4 times, use the power rule, and then somehow factor it and get back to this factored condition. Now in this one, we want to rewrite this as using a fractional exponent for our radical, and we're going to do the same thing we did here. So here our outer function is x to the 1/2, and its derivative will be 1/2 x to the negative 1/2 power. Our inside function is still h of x here, the same function, same derivative, so I won't rewrite that. So now when we apply the chain rule, we're going to plug our inside function into our g prime. And we're going to multiply again by h prime of x. Again, this is our chain rule. Now we can simplify. So on the top, we'll just have negative 3. And on the bottom, we'll have 2. And then we'll move the 2 minus 3x to the denominator to create a positive exponent. So these are two examples of using the chain rule. Now, for now, all the examples that we will be using the chain rule will be some expression to a power. In later chapters, when we introduce the logarithm functions and the exponential functions, we will have other applications of the chain rule. But for now, we're going to come up with a specialized version of the chain rule called the generalized power rule. And this rule applies specifically to when we have an expression or a blob raised to the nth power. For this to work, our expression on the inside, which I'm calling u of x in this formula, must be differentiable. And the exponent can be any real number. And we might have a constant multiplying out front. So if we have a equation that has a constant, some expression raised to a power, we can find its derivative right here. So this is straight from the chain rule, the pattern that we just had. So we're going to take the exponent times the number in front, just like the regular power rule. The expression inside stays the same. We do not change it. We do not take its derivative at this point. We subtract 1 from the exponent, and then we multiply, because of the chain rule, by the derivative of what was inside. So let's apply this to two examples. So again, we need to rewrite this as something to a power. So when we convert a third root, we convert that to a one-third exponent, and we have a 2 on the insides. So now our k is 1. This is our n. This is our expression. So when we find the derivative of y with respect to x, we're going to take the exponent times k. We leave our expression, our inside expression, alone. We subtract 1 from the exponent. And now we multiply by the derivative of what was inside. And now we just simplify. So we're going to use the commutative property to multiply those two things together. The 3 from this fraction goes in the denominator, and we're going to move this to the denominator since it has a negative exponent. And this would be our derivative, using the generalized power rule. And here, our last example, we need to rewrite, moving our expression in the denominator to the top so that we have our k expression to the nth power. Now we can apply the generalized power rule. So again, we take the exponent times our coefficient. We leave the blob or the expression alone. We subtract 1 from the exponent. And now we multiply by the derivative of the n sides, which would be 4. And now we just simplify again. We can use the commutative property to multiply those together. And because we have a negative exponent here, that moves to the denominator. And we change the sign of the exponent from negative to positive. And we have our simplified answer. So you can see the generalized power rule is fairly straightforward to apply, and it allows us to find the derivative of fairly complicated expressions. It's one of the most powerful rules that we'll be using this year. So good luck with experimenting with this rule, and we'll see you around.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Oh, are you ready to go? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready?